Finally, let's take a look at electromagnetic power. Let's take the time domain forms of Faraday's law and Ampere's law. We'll take H dotted with both sides of Faraday's law and subtract E dotted with both sides of Ampere's law. Using vector identities, this can be rearranged to this equation. Note that we are using the script forms of E, H, B, D, and J in order to be explicit about the fact that these are time domain quantities. We can then apply the divergence theorem to both sides of this equation to show that in a volume V surrounded by surface S, this relationship holds true. This relationship is formally known as the Poynting Theorem. It looks complicated, but it's actually just a statement of conservation of energy. This says that the net electromagnetic power flowing into a volume must be either stored in the electric and magnetic fields within that volume or dissipated as ohmic losses. We will also define this term, E cross H, as the Poynting vector. This is a vector that points in the direction of power flow, and it has units of watts per meter squared, which is a power flow density. Note that since both E and H are in the time domain, this is an expression of instantaneous power flow density. We can also find the time averaged power flow density, or time averaged Poynting vector, either by integrating over a period and dividing by that period, or by using this equation, where E and H are both expressed in their phasor form. Note that this is H conjugate, the complex conjugate of the phasor field H. Note also that E cross H equals S translates to a right-handed triad, E, H, S. So the right-hand rule can be used to find the direction of power flow if the directions of E and H are known.